Good morning, class 11. Welcome to your online class. We were doing the form chapter forms of education and we are in the ninth part of the chapter, and today we are going to discuss the responsibilities of a school. So in the last part of the video we have seen that what is a school basically, and according to Rabindranath Tagore's definition, we can say that it is like a place where the teacher and student will interact between themselves. They will have their personal talk along with the regular studies and whatever they are following during the session, and thus a good and cordial and healthy relation will grow. And over there they used to share their own personal feeling as well, and along with that, not only the relation between the teacher and student, there will be followed some basic rules, regulations, and the entire system will be bounded by some fixed rules and regulations. Now today I will start discussing the responsibilities of a school. Number one, preservative function. So if we say the word preservation, first, what do we understand? That preservation means to take care of something in its intact condition, isn't it? So why we are telling that there is a preservative function of the school? Because the old culture, the heritage, the tradition, what year after years the senior old person or the family and the society is maintaining, the same thing will be preserved by the school. Means school will keep its tradition, its heritage, whatever the year after year the school is continuing, the same according to the societal rules and regulations, the same will be followed by the administration of the school. Means they will follow the culture, the heritage. Like every year we used to celebrate Saraswati Puja exhibition, every year we used to follow Teachers' Day, like that. We will continue, the school will continue and preserve the good quality, the good heritage, the good tradition and the culture which are being followed from year after year. This is number one, function of preservation. Next one is transmissional function. Now, transmitting means what? When something is being passed on from one to the other. Transmission means where not only transformation, but transformation along with the enriched knowledge which I have received earlier. Transmitting means what culture, what heritage, what tradition I have learned, not only preserving them, but to transmit them to the next generation, or to transmit it to the next session. Means what? When suppose you are in class 11, when you will go to class 12, you will guide whatever you have learned during class 11 to the junior students, those who will come after passing Madhyamik exam, isn't it? So the school will also, or the school authority and the teachers will also take the responsibility of transmitting the knowledge and heritage and culture, whatever they have received and preserved. Just the previous one, preservation of the function and transmission of the function, means preservation, keeping it safe for them and for their generation is not okay, but further it is transmitting to the next generation is also a part of the function of the school. Next is integrating function. Now, what is the basic meaning of integration? We know to bring together, isn't it? Now see, why we are telling that there is a function of school as a integrating part. What is that basically? Now school is a place which is connecting between the two society, like family and the professional life or the society, isn't it? Whereas the life is becoming more complex. See, when a child is in a home, in his own home, he is totally protected by the parents. He is nurtured by the parents. If any requirement they feel, the parents used to give support, isn't it? In school also, a little bit surrounding and the atmosphere is changing. Over there, the child is mixing up with different sorts of students. They are coming from different background and they are working in a group form. They have to do a little bit more adjustment, and along with that, what is the school doing? The school is preparing yourself, preparing you and the students to be a better person by following some rules and regulations. Like what? You have to come in a proper dress, you have to come in proper time, otherwise you will be punished from the school authorities, isn't it? You have to come with a neat and clean dress. So all these features which are going on, these are helping you to be more perfect for your profession, isn't it? Further life, when you will join in a service, when you will go to a service life, when you have to take responsibilities more and more, you have to follow some rules and regulations. So these are enlarging the path of a regularized life. So this is what, why we are telling that it is, the school is taking integrating function, means it is integrating the two society of an individual's life, that is a school and the society, bigger society, okay? And school is helping you to adjust with the bigger society, adjust with the other people of the society. Next point, progressive function. This is quite obvious. Why do we change our curriculum? Why do we change our syllabus? The reason is according to the needs and demands of the society, isn't it? After some year or after some few years, the board or the school authority or the board authority, they used to decide that the syllabus must be changed, isn't it? Or the university authority, they used to think of changing the syllabus. But what is the reason behind it? Because the change of the society and requirement of the society, isn't it? So when the society is progressing, along with that upgradation, that along with that promotion or progress, the school will help the students to be progressive, not only in their mind but also knowledge and mind both, isn't it? If you do not progress yourself, if you do not change yourself according to the change of the society, then you will be at the back, isn't it? You will be lay behind, isn't it? So that is not desirable for us. So it will help us to, the school will help us to progress according to the change and progress of the society. Next point, developmental function. Progress and development are quite linked together, we can understand. When the progress occurs, there's a development. That both progress and development both can be positive and negative, but in case of school and school functioning, it is generally positive in nature, because what school is doing, it is for, they are working for the future citizen, they are working for the next generation of our country, of our society. So responsible to make a responsible citizen, isn't it? So the thing is, developmental function means here the school will take to develop the individual not only through his own, by his knowledge, but his all-round development, the word which we are reading right from the beginning, his social, mental, physical, aesthetic, spiritual, isn't it? So all sphere development will be helped by the school to develop in individual. So, and that will also enlarge the path of progress. So progress and development, both these two words are quietly correlated with each other, isn't it? One to the other. Next is corrective function. It is there's no need to explain that school is taking a big correctional responsibility. See, when you are doing something wrong, when you are doing something which is not desirable, which is not according to your age, school usually take the responsibility of correcting you, isn't it? Of checking or calling your parents and having a discussion about what are the problems occurring. It may be in some case deterioration of your result. Suppose in the last year you have done well, but this time you have not done. So why, what is the reason why it is happening? Maybe the school can, if any way the school can help. Like this, all these factors are being discussed with the parents. So indirectly they are helping the teachers, and the school is helping you to correct yourself if you have taken any bad way to enrich you or to get something, or it is motivational or anything. Well, if it is motivated, you are motivated by someone to do some bad works. So a contentious relation prevails in between the teacher and the parents. So that is helping you to correct your work what is wrong, as we consider it. Next point, guidance function. Guidance and correctional function is also more or less same point. Guiding you, that is done right from the beginning to end, not only by the knowledge, not only through giving you education, but also in your personal life. So when you feel problem, when you have some any type of social problem, financial problem, the school used to cooperate along with you for the so that you and your life can be run smoothly. So these are the more or less responsibility of a school, which is done by the institute, school as a formal institution. So all these points you are going to get in your book, and I think you have understood. It is when we will get live class, we will mark it, and I think it will help you more if you get the PDF along with the along with the video. So next day we are going to discuss what are the limitations of the school. Being an institute of formal education, there are some limitations of a school as well. So that we will discuss in the next day. Thank you.